we are teens. Let's go ahead and take your foot and start to roll it up these things over that bar. Just like typical, you can also do a different stretch while we work through our feet a little bit. You could do that foot prep we've been working on. And then slide to the outside rim of the foot. And inside. Dig into the heel. Crunch, crunch, crunch. And then the arch. And on the ball of the foot. Now, just like when we do that scroll this way, pinky toe to the big toe, and try and roll out where each metatarsal connects into the ball of your foot. And then full foot. Set that left foot down on the floor. Feel what that left foot feels like compared to the right. And then take that right foot and start to roll the right foot over your ball or body, whatever you have to use. So we're not only working off the kinks of the feet, but we're also getting more blood to circulate to the feet with that massage. And outside there. And inside there. I did a whole series of I wouldn't call it stretches, maybe stretches, massaging, and tapping for headaches yesterday. And really was like, okay, I'm going to be able to bring something of this to our time together, dig into the heel. But there wasn't one move. Yeah, it is super interesting. As someone with chronic headaches, it was interesting, fascinating, and information that I definitely plan to use. Hard to make time for all those things, but when you're in enough discomfort, I suppose. But all of them were things that I was like, just a tiny bit too big of a stretch, and especially felt, and then both. I feel like it's way easier when you can read the room when you're doing those types of things. But it's on the same thing, the reason, I also thought how smart it would be if we did face masks while we were stretching. I mean, if Gwyneth Paltrow can do it while she's on Zoom meetings and full foot, I thought, wouldn't that be so great if you put on like your moisturizing face mask and did your stretching? Yeah, and it's a lot of things. It's like manipulating your face and your yes, I guess there's still a little bit of pride left. And then go ahead and set your left foot and your right foot together. Feel those connect into the earth and then roll. We're going to do that foot stretch that we did on Tuesday. So right now, roll, ball of the foot, ball of the foot. Stretch all the way into those toes. And then just your right foot. Big toe to pinky. We're going to stay on that right foot and then push. Toes are into the floor, push forward. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Breathe. That was super uncomfortable for me. And go ahead and set your right foot. I'm very, I don't know if I would call it proud, but I'm very grateful and honestly pretty humbled for what we have in terms of the longevity that we've been here together in this space. Not only, and then big toe to pinky toe, not only online, because yes, that's a big feat, but also just together on this fitness journey to stay people, bounce from thing to thing all the time. So the fact that we're still together, I treasure that. And then take the toes. I definitely need to do more of this. This is like an IT band stretch for me. So as you take your toes, you're taking the tops of the toes and you're pressing them into the floor. Yeah. And then lean forward into that and kind of pull back away from it. It is definitely, I mean, I think of, because I was looking back through things because someone had asked me for something a long time ago. I was like, whoa, it's pretty amazing how far we've come. We're still at it. A lot of people have come and gone in that time. And go ahead and set your, we're going to do that one more time, but set your left foot down, cross your right. Now listen, as you cross your right, reach over to that right side first. Big breath in. It doesn't make it cramp, it just really hurts. And other side, it's like almost locked. The front of my foot is almost like locked, but it's the same like when we're supposed to be able, some of that's probably from all my broken toes and not like doing what I should. My left foot's a little better than my right. And come center. Now, take your right arm, bring it across, hold on to your ribs. Now take your left hand, bring it just about eyebrow level and gently pull your head over towards the left. Move your angle just a little bit to find where you're tight. I could see where that would cramp it though. Oh, thanks, please. And then come up nice and tall. Switch the leg, left leg comes on top. Reach over to the left first. And then over to the right. I will say, Chels, one thing I was super proud of myself with, and center, and not even, I don't know if that's even the right word, left hand, right ribs. Take the fingertips, the pads of the fingertips, right about eyebrow level, gentle pull. There was a time, like all the classes I'm taking, if that was a mouse or something in there. It's so hot in there, hopefully you're not climbing down the chimney. Move that head around a little bit. But there was a time I would have never taken some of the trainings that I'm taking right now, some of the classes. And I'm like, wow, remember? When I wouldn't even take time to do a pigeon stretch. You've come a long way. Inhale. And then exhale as we come up, uncross the legs. We're going to come right down into our back stretch because I have one thing that I want to trigger time for down here. So in this position, go ahead and lengthen the legs. Assess the tension in your back, the tightness in the back by seeing how long and high that back gap is. And then lift your hips, set the ball down right under the tailbone. And then the tailbone rests gently on that. Reach the legs up and then circle. When those memories pop up, it's so, you're up so early, question mark. I sure love you, Spurfies. And reverse, 5 years ago today was when we were at the White House. Time flies. And then flex your feet, little kicks. See if you can spread your toes. Yeah. What's crazy is that 5 years, you know, 5 years, that's, you know, not that long. And if you look at pictures of Ben, oh my gosh, 10 to 15 is huge. Ooh, tight hamstrings. Now take the legs out. Inhale. Exhale, close your legs, bend your knees, open your knees, hands are on the ankles, and then push your knees out. Inhale. Now as you exhale, take that left foot, place it on the right knee, pull the right knee towards you. Now you may need to use your hand to not fall over. So if I wanted both hands on the floor for balance, that's great too. If you can use your hands, you can pull this left foot so that the toes are more towards the shin. You can push that left knee away. You can pull that right knee in closer. Take the time on the exhale to release and let go. And switch. So once you find that balance on the other side, flex your right foot. You can roll through those little toe stretches and exercises if you want while you're right here. You pull that right foot back, the right knee away, and the left knee pulls in towards you. Big deep breath. And then go ahead and bring the legs to neutral. Straighten the legs, flex the feet open. Close the legs, bend the knees open. One more time, close the legs, straighten the legs, flex the feet. And open. Hands press away. And then pull. And close the legs. Go ahead and bend the knees. Set your feet down one vertebrae at a time. Roll your hips down into the floor, straighten the legs. Feel the gap after. Hopefully you have a little change from before and after. And then the chest sternum. You know me. Well, that's why I wanted us to have a little face mask on. I'm like, hey, while we're here, let's hydrate our skin, shall we? But same thing. I was like, you guys should. I don't really want to film that. Now with that ball right at the sternum or anywhere against the back that helps you to open up the chest, and then we take the arms out, we're just going to do one hug per side. So take a second to breathe here. Exhale out your mouth. Hug it in, right arm on top. Squeeze. Unwrap. big circle. And left arm on top, squeeze. Unwrap. Big circle. And then from there, roll yourselves up. Take the ball out of play. Once the ball is out of play, rotate over. Now we're going to come right into a lunge position for our hips team. So take your left foot forward. Your right foot is back. Pressing into that right hip for a second. So as we come into that, move around a little, loosen up your hips. And then from here, the width from your left foot to your right knee will give you a little bit more stability. So if you want to take it wider this direction, go for it. Then come up, you're leaning in. I'm going to give you a little cushion so I can enjoy the tension elsewhere. There we go. Not much better. And then take your arms and sweep them back. Last four. Three. Two. And one. Alternate right to left. Lean into that left knee. Two more. Last one. Now from here, take your right arm across the body. So we're trying to let our weight go and sink into this left leg. If you want, you could have your left elbow connected. So I don't know if you can see that. You can have your left elbow on that right thigh or left thigh. And then bring your hands down. Turn your left toes out. You can stay where you are or crawl down. Breathe. Push back into your hands. Reach back with that left hand. Option to hook the thigh or the torso. If it feels good to you to reach back and grab that left or that right foot, go for it. Big deep breath. As you exhale, turn back to center. Heel toe your left foot all the way across the mat and come into pigeon. It sure is. I'm really trying to get better on that. But yes, you're right. I feel like the more I read about so many things, the more I realize that when we don't let our bodies be still, things just get shoved in pockets. So trying to process through, reduce tension everywhere. Now, as you come down, if you come down, take your hands, interlace your fingers so that your thumbs are free. And then take your thumbs and apply pressure in between your eyebrows. Kind of copy that so you're just moving it around a little bit. Similarly, like if you have one of those face rollers that you use, picture similarly to that where you're just applying pressure, medium pressure. In between those, if it feels good to do a right, left, right, left, right, left, massage into that space. And part of the massage and stuff I was working on yesterday, it's amazing, like where I have so much tension versus where Vic does. He has very little. And like I carry so much stress everywhere in my face, my jaw, my sinuses. So just get to know when you're thinking about the pressure points and how that tension lies in your face. That can be closer to the temples. That could be closer to the outer portion of the jaw. Big breath in. As you exhale, push into your hands. We're finding so much that looking at a scream. I've always done tapping for more emotional stuff, but it's really interesting for blood flow. Set that left foot or right foot down. Come back up into that lunge, but this time the left knee is free. But it makes, and then come up, crescent lunge. So hard, there's so much to say. So hard to fit it all in. Left hand pulls that right shoulder over. Lots of hip openers today on purpose, friends. And then open it, turn towards your left. Inhale. Exhale, spiral the arms back up. Back bend. Back up. Arms out, turn your right toes out, warrior two. Yeah. And I'm gonna message you later about that, Lisa, because it's nothing, like I said, that I really want to spend video time doing. And take that left hand down, bring it up. But there's so much to that. Maybe we can challenge each other to work on it. Straighten that left leg. Soften the left leg, come up, and then reach into peaceful warrior. Big deep breath in. And then as we bring the arms back into that warrior two, spiral this right hand back up into crescent. Sweep the arms around, back to the floor. And then as we do so, you're going to flip the leg that's in front and drop. So now your right knee is in front, right foot is in front, left knee is behind. And then take a second to settle in. So the whole point of this hip opener that we've taken extra time to do is to get that to release and let go. So I want you to take a second to settle in. The weight is way forward here. Yes. Okay. Circle the arms back. There's and not only it's so good, like emotionally, physically, neurologically, but also like it will help so many things, like better for face tension and wrinkles and alternate right left. Sleep. Lean into that right thigh. It's going to want to grip and pull back, and you're going to feel so much fatigue. And a little bit of that is okay because we're after the left hip flexors. But try and see if you can lean far enough into that to kind of let go. And then hold. Take that left arm across. Option to lean in. Body's pretty amazing. With every exhale, see if you can release and let go of that tension in that hip. And then hands come down, turn your right toes out. See if you can stay here, or you can come all the way down. This side is tighter for me than the other. So if you have a pillow or yoga box, you can come down onto that. Press back into your hands. Reach back with that right hand. And an option, you could reach back, grab that foot. You can grab onto the opposite hip or rib. Your body is going to do this thing where you lift and grip tight, release and let it go. Even if that means you skip the next stretch because you're focusing on that breath and release, that would be more valuable. Now come center. As you come center, take this right foot, heel toe, heel toe, heel toe, drop into pigeon. Move around in that. Oh, good. I was hoping so. I went back and reviewed causes of low back tension, and hips were one of the top things. So I was like, okay, let's see if we can go after that today. Drop down. Now, we're going to spend about 40 seconds here, team, but same thing. You can take your thumbs into that space of the third eye, right in between your eyebrows, or if you're feeling confident, then take that all the way so you have the third eye. What I take is peace fingers, third eye, and then move it around occipital bone. So like move, you're taking, applying pressure. Yeah, and you know, it's all so connected that it's hard to know, like, okay, is this coming from a tight hamstring or a tight, like, I totally get it. But hopefully this will help. Roll across the eyebrows, team, so just right under the hairline of the eyebrows. And you're just doing a little press, mainly from looking at screens. So trying with those eyes closed, press into that just right under your eyebrow, giving a little bit of a press release, tap and back. And then do the same thing underneath, right across that cheekbone. Underneath towards your nose, and then back out. Take one more big deep breath. You have to pigeon for a long time there, chill. And then release the hands, shake them out. Big breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. Dig the left toes into the floor, tuck up onto that right foot. As you come into that, lift up into crescent. Now take your right hand, gentle pull on your left. Yeah, it's hard because right now there's blockage, so it's very painful. And I can't do a lot of the work that would be really helpful, like with one side breathing, like the nostril breathing. And come center, open the arms and twist. But yeah, it would. And then take this right hand, sweep it back into that crescent. Back in. Back into that. Reaching up, arms out. Turn your left toes, come into warrior two. But it was interesting because, and take that right hand down. Remember when we were talking to Sarah about Qigong and how that helped with her cancer rehab, straighten that right leg. So I signed up for a short little course on just like, that's beyond me. Bend the right knee, lift up, reach into peaceful warrior. But even just some of the practices of that, of just how energy flows and being an empath and then spiral down, turn your left toes. It just was fascinating. Drop that left hip and then send the right foot back, drop both hips, lift the head up and back. Feel the stretch to the skin in the front of the neck. Now let your thighs come down, flatten your feet. Your shoulders are going to want to be up here. We're pulling those down. Look over the left shoulder. Look over the right. See how extreme we can be with that. Come center. And then sink back into child's pose. Tuck your hips under. Let your face fall into the mat. Big deep breath in. And as you exhale, walk your hands back. We're gonna pull back into small ball. Lift the heels high so you're on your toes. Spread your toes. Bow your head. Take your head, look left and right. And then keep your head center and just take your eyes and look left and right. So your nose stays pointed towards the mat. Your eyes look as far left and as far right as you can. And then take your gaze back to your mat. Let your head hang heavy. Big breath. Whatever stress we can leave here, whether that's physical, mental, emotional, leave what you don't need to carry away from your mat. And then connect your heels. Lift your tailbone. Slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. As you come up, step your left foot forward. Press the top of your right foot into the floor. Twist towards the left. Come center and switch. Ah, so good. Twist. Thanks for being so open-minded. Well, I've crossed a little bit of a line today, but I'm grateful that you made it till the end. And come center, feet together. Big deep breath in, come into mountain. Exhale, back bend. Hands come back up. Bring your hands to your heart and forward fold. One more time as you allow your head to hang heavy. So we want to release the muscles in the back of the neck and the jaw and the face. Let it all go. And then one vertebrae at a time, roll yourselves up, squeeze your bottom, pull your belly button in, roll your shoulders back. Heart is open. Big, deep breath in. Oh, yay, Heidi. And exhale. Give yourselves a big hand. Awesome job, team. Thank you so much for being here. And again, seriously, that I feel like, Chelsea, I love it. I want to interject so much. Isn't it crazy, Heidi? And that's, I think, it's interesting because it was one of the things was talking about, like, that there's this heat trapped and you have to, like, release the heat. And there was this one method where you go into, like, where a baby has a soft spot, there's a point, and then you take, like, a ballpoint pen or anything, it kind of, not sharp, but firm and kind of pointed. And you take it into that and then just do 5 revolutions and then take it off and then massage it and then do that a couple of times. And you're trying to get all that trapped tension and release it through that space that, and it's the same thing like with your vagus nerve, your belly button hat, you can access so much. Anyway, it's interesting, but I won't geek out on it too much this morning. But just know that when there's little things that make sense, kind of, I can't tell if that's a joke or real, but what you are is it like, it goes down, like say it's here, say, so here there's an actual, like a finder that you get and you find the spot and it's, you go anyway, you find the spot and then you just do this. Like, remember those things in school? And then you massage it. Oh. Okay, I get it. We're joking. See, I got super excited that you wanted to do it. And then you would do that like 3 times. 5 circles, but it's the thing stays. And there's mine. And then you circle, but the point isn't moving. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. And then you massage it out, give it permission to release. It is. That's to help with sinuses and headaches. But anyway, there's a whole bunch of fun, cool facts. But I was laughing the whole time because it is ridiculous. You look ridiculous doing the movements. And then you just have to go like, check your ego at the door. But what I was going to say with that, and then I need to scoot, is that, well, I'm going to start interjecting like baby little pieces of information on that in a very safe space here. And then we won't do it all the time. We won't do much of it because some people are going to be like, ugh, not my thing. But
if something serves you, work it into this time. You have this short little time to do something so good for your body. So if the face massaging feels good, or literally, I'm not joking, like if putting a face mask on helps you kind of hydrate and get that taken care of at the same time as you're stretching, or even really using your massage tool to relieve stress and tension, do, I appreciate that. Do that at the same time so that you're getting all of this benefit. So I thanks, Heidi. Thanks for helping keep me inspired and not scared to move forward. So anyway, I love and appreciate you, team. Have a great rest of the day, and I will see you tomorrow for Pilates.